The reason why I love this scene is because they're both victims in the most extreme of ways.
That, for me, when we were putting it together, that was like the biggest thing.
Yeah, in so many ways, but like in their lives, they both have so little control of their own experience. And I just think that there's just something kindred about these two.
Yeah, they both nailed it.
We all thought you were, you know, batshit crazy.
Batshit?
Crazy.
I'm fully cognizant of her situation.
What did they do to you?
What they had to.
Did it hurt?
Yes. But it was necessary.
I'm sorry.
When I was editing it, I kind of wanted to make it seem like, oh, she's heard that before, but no one's ever thanked her for anything. So that's why choosing the next shot where she looks up to her, it's like she didn't expect
that. Yeah, Sarah's never had anybody thank her in her life, and she can relate to
her. I wanted to say thank you. I was only 11 when it happened, and my mother, she...
You're welcome.
You know, I always fantasize about doing that. So is it true what John said? That you can really speak to this thing?
The nanites provide a stabilized neural interface, yes.
I have to say, the music in this is phenomenal. Oliver Wickham did a phenomenal job.
Yeah, I worked with him a few times before this, and he always does a great job.
He nailed it, yeah.
But they said you up here to help us, right? I mean, isn't that why they sent you up here?
Yes.
I don't want to die, you know.
It's the first time you see her vulnerable, too, right?
I would even attribute Alex's character to being more vulnerable in that state, because Sarah just saw something she's probably never told anyone in her life. She knows something about her that no one else does. So that's why she's so open to her, and it makes a lot of sense.
And she's been inside of her mind.
Yeah, it's a testament to the writing.
That's nice of you, thank you.
How do you know?
I just do.